Hello friends, it's Simone. I'm here to share my final video for 31 inks, 31 pens, 31 letters. Today is May 30th, it's Thursday, and I have 2 days left. And so because I have found that it's really boring doing the last few days of this challenge, because I have exactly 2 inks left, exactly 2 pens left, I'm going to do them all at once. And I thought I would take you with me. That is going to be the first part of the video. Second part of the video, I'm going to show you all the pens and inks that I have used since day 24. I will do writing samples in my currently inked thingy majiggy. And then after that, I will do a little wrap up of this whole challenge, even though I know technically I haven't written with day 31 and day 30 just yet. But I feel like I know a lot about these pens here, so it's going to be fine. Okay, so I'm just going to take you all the way through how I did this every day. I usually got up, took care of my puppy, and then made myself breakfast. And while I was making myself breakfast, I would go over here into my studio area. I had all of this set up at my standing desk. And after the first 2 weeks of this challenge, I pre-selected ink samples. I talked about this in one of the videos, that I just wasn't really feeling it. And so I pulled out a whole bunch of samples, went through them, and put all of the ones that I was interested in here, left the ones that I wasn't quite feeling just now out. And I actually went through them again to see if there were any that I was feeling not at all. Those I took out. They were 5 in total, I believe. And then I threw all the other ones back. So I went over here, pulled an ink sample out of my box. This one is Lennon Toolbar Deep Mountain. And then I would put it into my sample vial holder, which is not here. So that's a thing. I would cut out these. I would rip this off, cut this out, because for some reason, I'm just not feeling this rectangle. I can't even tell you why it's different. It's almost see-through, but I'm just feeling the fussy cut version of this more. So I'm going through the trouble of fussy cutting this all out. The problem with these is that you need to actually align the date to align, because the feet aren't you always on the same horizontal line. So if you set the feet straight, then sometimes your day is skewed. And what I also found very interesting, which is completely off topic, is that most of these ladies look towards the left. So I ended up sticking them down always on this side. I can't have someone looking off the page. Maybe if I had put this right here, then that would be okay. But I just cannot have this look to the side. So that's basically how I always do this. So I'm taking this off. Then I usually have some kind of paper, because this Cosmo Air light paper that I'm using as an ink journal for 2024 and possibly beyond is very, very susceptible to hand oils. So now see, this is not really straight, so this is falling off this direction. It's very susceptible to hand oils, so I usually, when I'm working on this page, I cover this side completely with a pencil board. So when I put my hands on here, I don't accidentally mess up the page. And then let me grab my thing. Well, I'm already unscrewing the top, but that's not something that is super important to have on video. And then I would swatch this here. I'm just gonna do it over here. And then I wouldn't rinse it just yet because I also usually swatch these. Oh, interesting. I would call this a blue-green. Then I would grab my swatch book that I haven't updated. And here is my full-size pencil board. I can put this right here now. My idea was to log all of my, or swatch all of the ink samples that I had. But when I was doing swatching videos, that was just too much. I have a cat on the desk, so let's see how that is going to go. Please, hello, sir, move your butt out of here. Blue green. On my standing desk, I have a little bit more room, so I was able to do this off on the side. Then I would small drop here, and now I'm ready to rinse this. Did I already say what ink this is? I think I did. And then clean this off. And then I usually use my Pilot Iro Utsushi in this notebook, because even though this is a medium nib, it's a very fine line. Lennon Toolbar. Deep Mountain. I was, for some reason, I thought this had something to do with the ocean. And then while this was drying, I would wonder what pen I would use. Now I have two pens left. Maybe I'll use this. So I have a 1.1 stub nib on here, and for some reason I'm actually feeling the broads more than the stubs at the moment. And so I feel like if I'm putting this in here, I'm doing this ink injustice, but then I would have the next ink for tomorrow, which is Sailor 50 States Nevada in here. And for some reason, because I am currently living in Nevada, I want this in a pen that I might enjoy. So that's the really biggest disadvantage of having, I said this in the last video, I have exactly 31 pens, and the only reason why I have 31 pens is because this one didn't work out for copper patina, and I did a redraw that day and emptied out this pen. So technically I have used it, but theoretically I haven't. Maybe theoretically I haven't, and practically I have used it. So then I write the ink name here. This is Lennon. Well, actually it's not as bad. Maybe I was just, but, okay, I have to burn my book again. Ah, fuck. It's capitalized. Deep. Mountain. This is just because I'm filming this now. Okay, and then this is the Twisby. Ego. In white. With a 1.1 stop. And then I would write. And I think I'm going to speed this up, so I'm not going to talk about this. I hope you were able to follow along. Basically, I have just written what I told you about earlier. And I talked myself basically out of liking this pen. I was really hesitant to use it and it feels really great. So I need to keep that in mind when moving forward, when I am thinking about letting pens go. Maybe I need to let it ruminate more, not thinking, but using it one or two times more before making the actual decision of letting it go. Because I would have probably said before this video that I wasn't happy with this pen and that I would gift it to someone. But nah. I really like this 1.1 stub. So then that would be it for my journal. Oh, that is not true. This needs to dry and then I would have to put the ink in here. I am going to wait for that until my day 31 is going to be done as well. I totally messed up when I added this in. I didn't do it every day. So I just filled it in yesterday, I believe, and I forgot day 27. So here's day 28, 29, day 27. But let's move on to day 31, the 31st of May. And do this all over again. And then I would, in the afternoon, so that this is all done before I go get ready for work. And then when I get home from work or after dinner, sometime during the afternoon before I go to bed, usually, I haven't been as it since my daughter moved home last Wednesday, even though she's not, you know, disturbing me, I feel like I'm having an adjustment period where I'm even more tired, or we're eating dinner late, we're sitting longer at the dinner table and talking. And so it's like, okay, do I now sit down and write this note? Or actually, I wanted to write a letter to this person. I can't even think a straight thought anymore. So I'm going to bed and haven't written the card. So I am currently, I haven't even worked on yesterday's letter note because I know I want to write a letter to that person and not just send a sticker. I send a sticker right on the back and that's my letter. But yeah, I haven't done yesterday's. So, and then I will have to do today's and tomorrow's sometime during the next 2 days, like today or tomorrow. I'm just going to keep on putting it over on this side. I don't care. I was giving myself lots of grace with these notes as long as I was, you know, going and doing them more often than not. I was happy and besides day 29, day 30, and day 31, I'm done. I did finish. So day 23. I also knew I was going to write a letter to this person. I had put them into my planner ahead of time, like every name. And so I knew I wanted to write a little bit of a longer letter to this person. And that kept me from writing the notes for day 24 and day 25. And then I just decided to skip ahead and continue working on all of the notes, the smaller notes, so I wouldn't fall behind. And then I just, yesterday I had some time and I went back to the person from day 23. So I am really amazed that I was able to keep up with that. I did not absolutely think I would be able to. And I was okay with setting myself lofty goals and failing. I knew ahead of time So my original thought when I went into this was that I wouldn't do anything, you know, anything in the sense of I'm not sharing a currently inked on YouTube or so in June. I could keep some of the pens around from this month, or I don't know. And if I was failing on writing the notes, I would, what is this color? Let's ink the pen first. I would then just finish up the notes and letters that I hadn't got to during the month of June. That was my original plan. When I realized that I was actually being able to keep up, why is there a hair in the mechanism right here? When I was, when I noticed how well this was going and that I was most likely be able to succeed, I then came up with my summer challenge, which I think I talked about this last week briefly. And I will share a more in-depth video next Saturday. So I'm just going to keep on sharing weekly update videos. What am I doing? This is a Benu Euphoria. This is a Goulet exclusive. Man, and they have come out with two amazing exclusives, just like one after the other. There is a pink one, like bright magenta pink-ish, that I really love. And then the matcha latte, I think is it's called. I am really loving the Euphoria model. I love the Schmidt nibs. They work really well. I didn't have any problems with my medium and broad nib that I have. However, I need to just address that both fine nibs that I received in my two Benus that I purchased were a bit wonky in the beginning. Like they were scratchy and they didn't flow well. So I flossed them. I widened the tines just marginally, and then I checked if the tines were misaligned and I smoothed them out on some micro mesh, and now they're working really well. However, if you're not having that, oh my gosh, this is so smooth and this is so wet, maybe you have a fine nib and you need to tweak it a little. And even though I don't really encourage you to just go and do that, you can purchase the Schmidt nib units separately. So if you were to mess up, that would be a $30 loss. I purchased my spare nib units. I also purchased a spare nib unit for my smaller number 5 Benu Brown Ambrosia Brown Orchid. Is it called that? I don't know. It doesn't really matter right now. From Goldspot Pens, and so including shipping, it's about $30. So if you were to mess up playing with, trying to mess with your nib and adjusting it, and, you know, dipping your toes into that, I would just put this under brown. You're not messing up $150. You're only messing up $30. I hope that makes sense. So yeah, I wanted to say that because I have had on my Discord, I have had multiple people say like, I don't have the same experience as you all do. what is wrong with me? I don't believe there's anything wrong with you. Maybe you need to make sure that your ink isn't dry, but I haven't, even when I put dry inks into my Benu pens, they flow really nicely. So yeah, I have something to say about Benu Euphorias later. That was just an analogy that I did when I thought about my palette Kakunos. But I would, if I hadn't put myself into a pen buying moratorium, I would probably be the proud owner of two new pens from Goulet exclusive Benu Euphorias. So this is Sailor, 50 States, Nevada. So I did not have brunch date, Colorverse brunch date yet. I don't know if I still have it in my sample stash or if I decided that I'm not interested in it. And I haven't used Taranishi Opera Rose, but this is leaning very pink, dusty pinkish, orangey. And I could imagine that this is a very similar ink. And if you have used Sailor 50 States Nevada and you have used any of the other inks that I just referred to, I would love to know if I'm completely off or if that is true. So, Bennu Euphoria Earl Grey Tea. Is it Earl Grey or Earl Grey Tea? With a medium nib. And now I'm trying to be able to write with a... The only problem with putting the swatch right here instead of over here is that now I have to like... squeeze myself by Sailor 50 States. And the Sailor 50 States inks are, I think they're 20 milliliters and they're quite expensive. But I don't know, I am feeling drawn to buying just California and Nevada for sentimental reasons. Would you do that? I mean, I also know that I like the colors. That's a benefit. But would you do that? I feel like I should. Yeah, I'm building my cards everywhere. Let's not talk about this. I'm on a pen buying moratorium right now. And with a medium nib. Oh my gosh, this is so smooth and so wet. So I am going to write really quickly down here and then I will be back. I do actually feel that this Diamine Sepia might be very similar, and I am just going to... I pulled out my glass dip pen, and I've seen so many people use that as a swatching tool, and I just wanted to try it, and so that's what I've been doing recently. Is using this as a swatching tool, and I actually really, really enjoy doing that. No, this is more golden and this is more pink leaning. So there would be a possibility to add this to my bottled collection without duplicating a hue. I mean, they are similar, but they're not the same. That's what I've been doing lately. I didn't so much grab any of the samples that I had, even if I knew that maybe they were close, except for one exception. But I was comparing the inks to my ink bottles that I had. Okay, so here are all the pens that I have used. These were basically the leftover pens, or the very newest addition to my collection. This is ink, not blood. And they were basically the leftover pens. And that made this whole week a little bit less exciting. And I have some thoughts on that. And let's go in. I am putting stuff away here first so that I can manage all of this. I should have done that before I started filming the second part. This is the Pelican Twist. I received this as a gift from my friend Nikki. And I inked it on the first day, so Friday the 24th, with Nagasawa Kobe Chaska Green. Now, this green reminded me very much of Diamine Salamander that I had used on that Monday. I had switched out the nibs. This is a a beginner's nib, so A für Anfänger. Day 24. And what I noticed when I used this for my note, Kobe ink, Chaska cream, is that I am not enjoying the triangular grip. It, compared to the Lamy or even the Twisby Eco T and the Kakunos, they also have a slight triangular grip. This is extremely pronounced and I don't get along with it. All the other nibs, grips, I don't have a problem with, but this one, Pelican Twist. And so this is one that I will pass along. I will remove the beginner's nib and put the original nib back in here, and then I will pass this along to a friend. So let's check for Salamander right here. So actually it was like 2 days before. On the Cosmo Airlite paper, this Diamine Salamander looks a lot more murky than the Chaska Green. And one thing that I have realized throughout this whole month is that I don't mind murky, swampy inks, but or any ink in general. But what I don't appreciate about an ink is when it's vastly different on different papers, like this one, like Weeping Willow, like Salamander. So I'm swatching this on here and then I'm using it on a different paper and it looks completely different. I'm totally fine with an ink looking a little bit more warmer or cooler, or there's a gray hue that wasn't there before. If the base color still remains basically the same, that's okay, but I don't prefer inks that look super different, change color, are color changing basically on different papers. So if I were to have to choose one of these, I would probably choose the Kobe ink, because it was just more like, you know, these two hues are the same. Let's check Salamander over here. This is dark green. This is basically the same color as this one. And it's Merc City over here. So that's not something that I like. So I'm glad I learned this. This is why I'm doing this whole experiment. On Saturday, the 20 day 25, I used my Extra Fine 14K gold nib on this Lamy All-Star in Petrol, I believe is the color name for this. This is the nib that made me go out and buy all the sizes. I received this as a gift and then I purchased the other nibs. But the ink on here, in here, is Sailor in collaboration with Tokyo Hands. It's a stationery store, I believe, in Tokyo. And this is an ink that is really hard to get if you're not there. My friend Amy gave me a sample of this. It totally reminds me of Diamine Brandy Snap. And so I'm okay with not being able to obtain this ink. It's nice to try and use, but it's not an ink that I would go out and buy. If I didn't have Brandy Snap in my stash, this was easily accessible, I might. Day 25. But this nib, everybody always says, oh, those Lamy nibs, they're never reliable. You never know what you get. An Extra Fine could look like a broad. I need to write Tokyo Hands. Taisha Euro. Is Euro gold? I'm not sure. Because this is so broad. Well, first of all, it looks like an architect nib. And then it's super broad and very wet. And I'll show you the writing sample that I did with the fine 14K nib. And it looks like the fine 14K nib is the extra fine and this one is the fine. But I checked, the writing on this nib is the extra fine. So yes, it could be the difference in inks, but where is it? Now I don't remember when I used it. Here. I'm just going to write next to it right here. Extra fine. Like, let's write fine right after. Okay, like, this is fat compared to the fine here. And I would assume that this is how it looks usually, because the Pilot Iroshizuku inks that I had put into this are usually pretty fairly wet. So yeah. Now I need a writing blotter paper, blotting paper. Let's put this right here. So I am really happy with this nib. It's super wet. It's lovely, but I wouldn't say it's an extra fine nib. No, it is not. Then day 26 is my newest addition. I have an unboxing video coming out soon. This is Little Pens Design. This is their in-house blank. Look at the star. I love it. It's a stargazer. It's a, I don't know if they say if it's a smoke, if it's a specific colorway. This is purple, obviously. And it's their Acadia model. And my friend Lorelei purchased, he had one of those. That's the only thing I have noticed with this, but it might also be the ink. So I have noticed that this, do you want the story? My friend Lorelei purchased a pen like this from Little Pen Designs in November of 2023. And when I saw that, I immediately wanted that pen. I reached out and he said, well, unfortunately, I won't be able to buy more of those, this resin. It's not as good as I had hoped it would be. So I'm working on making my own resin and I'll let you know when I'm ready to sell those. And so when he started sharing those on his feed on Instagram, I reached out and said, so how does that commission process actually work? And he told me, and then I really felt like I needed it right now. And so I did. I commissioned it and I purchased it in the middle of the month of May, beginning of May. That was my very last pen. The ink that I pulled here is Organic Studio Aldous Huxley. And yes, I like the sheen on this. I like the color, but I probably would not purchase a bottle because I'm seeing these hard starts. I haven't had hard starts in this journaler nib. It might be the cap that isn't sealing well, so I'm definitely going to try this with an ink that I know better. In this pen. But I have noticed that the ink that I just showed you earlier, Pilot Iroshizuku Shoro, is almost basically the same color as Organic Studio Aldous Huxley. And I know that Palette Iroshisuku inks are very reliable, very easy to clean. So if I was going to add a color in that color spectrum, I would probably add Soro. But I'm going to... Is the ink converter empty? No, it doesn't seem like it. So is it not seated? It is. It's not flowing really well. There we have it. Yeah, I'm going to try this pen with others, and I'm going to go through my own ink bottles, my ink bottle stash, before adding any more inks. And that is the journaler. So whenever I'm talking about, oh, I would love to buy a bottle of this ink, I mean that after I have gone through my stash and I have reacquainted myself with all of the inks, seen if I like them all, seen where I have gaps or multiples of, I'm fairly certain that I have multiple colors of in this shade, so I don't even know if I would necessarily need, you know, what kind of ink colors do you even have to add? One is fine. If I necessarily have a gap in that color spectrum and if I wanted to add one, but if I were, it would be Soro. That was like a 5-minute talk about why I'm not going to buy Organic Studio Aldous Huxley. I appreciate being able to try the sample, but I think I'm not someone who loves to deal with... I know that already. I know that I don't like dealing with high maintenance inks. Then I pulled Birmingham Pen Co. Magnolia Mirage, which is a sample that I received from my friend Jana. This one was from my friend Kelly, Amy. So I know exactly who I receive ink samples from, which is something that makes me very happy. It feels like I'm connecting to the community in that way. So I swatched that here, and when I swatched it, I already knew that I probably wouldn't like this in a writing sample, but I still wanted to keep it and see, because here, the blue purpley things that basically fell out of the ink and made it chromo shady looked lovely. And now in a pen, it very much reminds me of Pelikan Edelstein Rose Quartz. It's almost, so this is on the same paper. It's almost the same in my eyes. And I put it into the Lamy 2000. And it confirmed my fear, not really fear, my knowledge that this is a color that is not for me. Which is okay. I mean, sometimes you just need to confirm again. Like, do I really not like this? Yeah, you actually really don't. Day 27, Birmingham Pen Co., Magnolia Mirage. And this is the Lamy 2000 in a fine nib. Now, I really like this pen. I know that I've said this before, that I, now that this is a fine nib, I'm really in love with it. Since I purchased the gold nibs for my Lamy Safari type pens, I have not fallen out of love with the Lamy 2000, but maybe it's recency bias. They are new. I haven't used them much. Every time I use them, I'm excited. This is just normal excitement. This is high excitement level. If I had to choose right now, I would choose these pens and nibs over this pen. Of course, this is really easy to say because I have all the sizes in these nibs. I have only a fine in the Lamy 2000. It makes me want to try and see how a medium nib feels. I started out with an extra fine and now I'm working my way up. So at the moment, this definitely takes this. You can't even see. The Lamy 2000 definitely takes a back seat behind the Lamy Gold nibs. So if you were wanting to add a Lamy Gold nib and you don't have a problem with the grip section of the Lamy Safaris, that would be my choice. So then I'm down to 4 pens. This is day 28. I have my two Kakunos left, the Twisby Eco and the Benu Euphoria. There's no real reason why I haven't picked the Benu Euphoria yet, but I have been skipping over the Kakunos, not really wanting to use them. But when I counted and checked whether I had any pens, how many pens I would actually be able to corral to do this challenge, I found that, oh well, I will have to use the Kakunos, otherwise I'm not going to use 31 different pens, which is not a requirement, but if I have 31 different pens, I could make it a requirement day 28. So this is the Pilot Kakuno in clear with a fine nib. The ink that's in here is Sailor Manyo Ume. I received this sample. Wow, they look vastly different right now. I received this sample from my friend Amy very early in my fountain pen journey. And I always skipped over it. And I can't really tell you why. Because when I swatched this, I instantly fell in love with the ink. And I can show you some comparisons down here. But maybe it's not a great pairing with the fine nib. It feels a little scratchy. It's almost too fine for my liking for colored inks. I would totally use this with a black ink in a, permanent black ink that I use in art or so, but I am not really drawn to this pen at all. I'm really drawn to the ink. And I then compared Spicy Chipotle that I had used the week prior, which is right here. This is a bit browner. This is more red. Then I also compared it to Diamine Writer's Blood. That is a little bit more blue. And then I also have Robert Oster Old Book Smell, which I think is more orange. So they're all very, very similar, but they're not the same. I'm not sure. Again, this is an ink that I would add to my ink bottle stash. Not sure I will do that right now or when I'm off my moratorium, but it's definitely an ink that I'm really liking. Not necessarily in this pen. And then the next ink that I pulled was Diamine Bah Humbug. This is the second shimmer ink this month. I have not had any interest in shimmer inks. No, this is the third. Copper Patina was one that didn't work at all. So this is the third shimmer ink. I haven't really been drawn to shimmer inks lately, and I wanted to use them in pens. But when I then inked up this Kakuno, because I was like, do I really want to waste these two pens on a shimmer ink? This was the only pen that was left. And the ink is a, yeah, it's nice. You can use it, but it doesn't give me anything. It doesn't make me excited. Like Colorverse Brain, for instance. This one was, I was super excited about this ink. I would totally break any rules that I have set on not purchasing ink bottles for this ink, not for this one. So I would not add this to my ink bottle stash because I would rather keep the spaces for shimmer inks, which I want to keep at a minimum. to inks that really get me excited about them. And then the pen. It's another, I'm not excited about this pen. And so I've been thinking about this. What is the reason why I am keeping these two pens? I know they're cheap. That's one reason I could make, like, one argument. Another one is they're easy to clean. You can pull the nib and feed really easily from here and take the whole pen apart. So it's good for shimmer inks. Maybe it's functional, you know. I could use this for art making, like put some really tough inks in there that I wouldn't want to put in any of my more expensive pens. But I would need a specific category for this pen. Like, this is a functional pen that I only use for very specific purposes that I don't know yet. Because I'm not drawn to these pens in my everyday pen usage. So if I had all of those pens inked, as I have right now, I would always gravitate towards any of the other pens, probably even the Pelican Twist, than those. They don't excite me in the least. And yes, there is, you can, I don't even know if you can actually, yes, here, if you look at it from here, you can see that this has a triangular grip section. But there, when I wrote with them, I felt really cramped. I wrote a letter yesterday, and I used definitely this one. And I'd rather use a Benu Euphoria. And I think I would probably save up, add another Euphoria, which also works really well with shimmer inks. Inks that I might be afraid to put in any of my gold nibbed pens. But to be honest, this Colorverse Brain I put into my Pelican M800 and it performed amazingly. It still performs amazingly. It still writes really well. I used it in the letter yesterday. The shimmer distribution was perfect. And yes, of course, I totally understand that this pen, the price of this pen, I don't even know the math off the top of my head. So much more expensive than this pen. Yes, totally understandable. But I have this pen in my stash and I can use it with shimmer inks. And so now, do I just keep this? Because why? I'd rather probably save my money and don't buy any more of the cheaper pens until I have, like, every time I feel the urge, I need to get another Pilot Kakuno, which I don't have the urge, but let's just theorize right here. Every time I feel the urge to buy another cheap pen, let me just put that money into a piggy bank and wait until I have the funds for another Euphoria that I then could dedicate to only shimmer inks or something. That would totally excite me more in a challenge setting like this than inking up these Kakunos. So now you already saw me. I'm just going to add these to complete the 31 inks and days in this notebook. That's where I'm at right now. I don't even know what conclusion I'm drawing from this. I'm just, you know, I'm just thinking out loud right here. And I will I'm not breaking my bank or I'm not hurting my wallet if I'd keep those pens. One of them was a gift. The other one I purchased from Amazon for like maybe 14 bucks. So I don't have to sell them in order to afford anything else. And again, I'm on a pen buying moratorium that I'm hoping to keep to take seriously. Doesn't sound promising. But I would like to at least make it to the San Francisco Pen Show without buying anything. Not because I need to, keep my money. That's a nice side effect. I want to do my ink summer project, and I want to use all of my pens. I want to learn about my pens without having two more, without my thoughts being distracted by what pen am I going to buy next? I want to focus my whole attention and energy on the pens I own instead of taking some of that energy away to the pens I would buy next. I still like looking at all the new things that come out, and I'm certainly not immune to not wanting anything. Earl Grey. Okay, that's what you get from talking while writing Sailor on day 31. I mess up. 50 states. Nevada. Yeah. So that's my conclusion-ish. I started out this project with 154 samples in my sample stash, I believe. Then in the first week, I went down to 117. That sounds not right, but well, I might just recount all of them. Then I went down to 104, and I didn't count last week, but at the end of this project, I am down to 88 samples in my sample box, which is phenomenal.
It's editing Simone here. I just retraced all of my steps, recounted all the samples, and I have 109 samples still in my sample box.
I didn't realize when I was accumulating the samples how overwhelmed they would make me feel right now. I thought about maybe turning this around and picking the pen randomly, but I wouldn't even know how to start picking the ink then. So there's that. So I'm really glad that I'm down to 88. I am going to take a sample break until September 1st. I'm focusing my summer project on all of my ink bottles, which I am hoping to get through and using by before the San Francisco Pen Show. I'm not planning on buying a lot of things at the San Francisco Pen Show at the moment, but just if I wanted to buy a bottle, I would have an idea of what I might want. And also, I will see quite a few people at the San Francisco Pen Show, so I could also take all of the bottles that I am not going to keep with me and, destash them there. Unfortunately, for some reason, I don't. Well, of course, I used 32 samples. I destashed more. But I don't really know. Well, of the ones that I use, so of the 32 inks that I have used, I am going to keep 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if I had to narrow it down even more, I probably would throw Harahara back and keep Tachiya Umemurasaki. They're really similar, not the same, but they're really similar. And this one trumps this one. I'm keeping Pilot Iroshizuku Syoro. I'm also keeping Aldous Huxley. Well, actually, nope, not keeping that. So I'm keeping eight. I'm keeping Pilot Iroshizuku Fuyu Sogan. This is a really high top contender for an ink bottle. This one I want to purchase at the San Francisco Pen Show. I want to see how the tremendous Alexander Hamilton, or it's the same as Aubergine, performs in a dry pen. I think I'm going to get rid of this. I want to buy a bottle of Colorverse Brain. I want to see how this looks. I'm keeping Business in the Front, Party in the Back, mainly to compare it to Pink Cliff by Lamy. And then, because I really loved this so much, I want to use this in another pen that is not a Palette Kakuno. I'm keeping Sailor Manu Ume. So, two, four, six, seven pen, seven ink samples I'm keeping of the 32 that I have used during the month of May. And I think that's really amazing that I'm keeping those. I'm not counting those in my sample box count because these are keepers for now. Maybe I want to use them again. I will not use them in my 30 inks, 30 days, or September challenge either because I really want to get through that, those 88 samples and get them down to a manageable number. All right, what else? This challenge kept me engaged from day one to day 31. I didn't think I would have so much fun with this. It was the right thing that I needed at the right time. Because I have a puppy, I don't really journal much with fountain pen inks. Having to write a note to a friend made me use that pen on the day. I was swatching, I was writing in my ink journal, I was doing some things every day. It was awesome. It filled my cup so tremendously that even though I did receive quite a few pens in May, I have not felt the urge to give in to any other pens that I saw out here. And I hope this is going to continue throughout the summer. I swatched, I wrote, I thought about the pens, I thought about the inks, I thought about, you know, why I like this ink more than the other, or what is it that doesn't draw me into this pen? I talked myself into not liking pens, and when I used them, I was like, what was I even thinking about? So I just flipped through this and I have a new pen day on May 2nd. I have a new pen day on May 8th. I have a new nib day on May. I think I purchased all of those in April. So I think if I'm saying that I did not buy a pen besides the commission that I commissioned before May 1st, but I had to pay it after, I did not buy a pen since May 1st. And I would attribute that to the fact that I was with my pens and using my pens every single day. There was never a lull where I can't get to my pens. Maybe I should buy one. That's how I often you buy stationery when I'm not able to journal and I really want to play with it, but I don't have time. Then I buy stuff because it also feels like I'm doing something with stationery. So I did see the matcha latte, the other pink pen that Goulet exclusive Euphoria. I totally saw them. Some of my friends bought some amazing Waterman Karen pens. Like, would I like this pen? Would I not? No, I was able to be happy for them without having to go and push the checkout button. I didn't even add them to cart. So June 1st, I'm going to start my bottle project, which is going to be a tiny bit different. I don't know. We'll see the rules evolve as I'm going. And I'm really excited to share that journey with you as well. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. I really appreciate you watching this super long video. Thanks so much for going on this journey with me. I will see you again next time. Bye.